think of childhood friends and the dreams we had. We lived happily forever.
Oh, man.
So the story goes.
Days like today are draining.
Okay, we should be live. Somebody want to check that for me?
Yep, you're up.
You're
up. I see you.
Okay.
You even have quality options, sir.
Ooh, a scary bot.
No, I'm not air drumming. You're air drumming.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to the chaos. The only way to put it, of our wonderful group that we haven't played in 2 months thanks to a heart attack on my part. But thanks very much. Welcome to Pirates of Greyhawk. This is our D&D game with Timid Joe Numbers, Ray, Mr. Joe Tobin, Mr. Blue Moo, and normally Fluffy, but Fluffy's gone, and I don't know where Sumi went. So,
you know. I'll keep trying.
Okay, well, I mean, yeah, nah, he'll be here. I'm pretty sure he's been bothering me for three months on this, so I'm pretty sure he'll be back. It's just a matter of
when he comes back.
Yes, Sumi is wrangling cats.
Yes. When he disappears, the cats have attacked and eaten him.
I could have made a really. Okay, never mind.
I do have a co-GM today.
Okay.
If you see him on stream. Hey, oh, that's Scrimmicky Frog.
Yay.
Yes, I finally found a Kermit the Frog.
Oh, nice. You never had one of those already?
No, I didn't. So,
I figured you would have had one of those.
Well, the story on him is that this is actually the wrong one. I wanted to get an actual hand puppet Kermit so I could stream with the hand puppet.
Like the Perliquist, kind of.
Yeah, but instead, that's not what they told me this was, and it turns out this is one of those. This is a Beanie Baby, the Beanie Baby tie company makes Beanie Babies. This is their version of Kermit.
Bloody hell, Beanie Babies! That's going back a bit.
Yeah. So, we got a Kermit now. So.
Oh, wow! I just looked up a Kermit for a hand puppet.
Yeah, it's a couple $100.
I just saw it for $900 on eBay.
Yeah, that's the real ones. I don't want. It would be really nice to have one of those. It ain't happening. I know better. All right.
Oh, it looks great.
No, it's pretty. The mouth is a little off, but other than that, it's perfect for what I want to do anyway. So, it's cool. All right. And as this finally fades away, 2 months ago, God, I hate to say it that way, but God, actually, it's been 3 months now. Oh my God, thinking about it, it's been over 3 months now. Because I had the heart attack on tax day. Figure that. We really haven't played anything since then. No, we're not playing Bruno Mars. Okay. It wanted to all of a sudden kick to Bruno Mars songs. All right. So kind of a recap. This is what we're going to be needing. Our group of adventurers, after solving a poisoning in the city of Greyhawk, a case where a group of cultists were attempting to poison the water and convert everybody to worship of the Earth Dragon, aka Tiamat, the party got shanghaied by a pirate and his crew, and were brought on board of the ship called the Wormwood. The pirate, I can't remember his dumb name now, so check my notes here.
Barnabas Harrigan.
Yeah, you have it written down. Yes, Barnabas Harrigan. And this is, by the way, those that that might be familiar with Pathfinder, this is me adapting the Blood and Shackles adventure path. So some of the stuff is going to be the same, but after we get past a certain point, it's all going to be brand new. But I'm trying to get the party to that point. Hopefully it'll be within the next two sessions. So Barnabas Harrigan and his wonderful crew, including Mr. Plug, who is in charge of disciplining the shanghaied player characters, are pirates that are right now are in the sea that is south of the Bright Desert and east of the Wild Coast is approximately where they're at. It's south of the city of Greyhawk. and from what we know, the pirate captain's current plan is to train everybody as pirates, capture a bunch of ships, and become a pirate king. One ringy dingy.
The pirates upgraded their technology and came out with phones.
Yeah, they're using cell phones now to coordinate between the ships. It's kind of a neat situation.
Than flag.
Oh wait, no, that's tomorrow night's group. Okay. Anyways, we're going to do Star Wars again. Finally, although that group's bounty hunters, so we'll see. Okay, so Master Scourge and Mr. Plug are really truly the two antagonists that we need to worry about on this ship. Now the party, hey. Because my voice goes nuts. It's kind of it's not really a kind of an official party. It just kind of got thrown together. We have, for character class, we have a dwarf rogue. Say hello, dwarf rogue.
Hello, governor.
Played by Joe Numbers. We have a tiefling druid, which is played by Timid. We have a human, I believe, cleric?
Yes.
Female?
Yes.
We have a human bard?
Hello.
It's Blue Moon. And we have a elf ranger?
Hello.
That was played by Ray. And we're missing our, I can't remember what, he's a worgen or something. He's like a wolf. He's a wolverine, but he's a shifter. So that would be Sume when he's here. And our goblin alchemist who is not here tonight, which is Fluffy. I think I got everybody. The party has met a couple people already on board the ship. The first one is Fishguts, the cook, who is a really ugly, ugly looking human. Big, fat, out of shape. I looked at his picture. I don't want to slam Burke Black, but he looks a lot like Burke. you've also met Sandera Quinn, who is a up and coming cleric, who is a who wants to be a pirate cleric. And then last is Conchobar, the gnome bard, with his giant purple hat that makes him look like he was part of the Three Amigos. And considering he's a gnome, it really looks really bad on him. But the bard, he makes it look good. So, that's just a few of the people you've met. Now, when we got done with the last session, we had basically the party is assigned a series of tasks on the ship for their duties. Hope you guys remembered what you guys are. I don't remember, except for Fluffy is the cook's mate. The aide to the cook.
To be honest, I'm not sure if I had a role yet.
Okay. Well, it basically would have. Let me find the roles here.
I remember being a runner.
Okay. Yeah. There was a. You were. Okay, the runner is the one who delivers messages back and forth along the ship. The rigger, I know somebody's a rigger.
I got assigned to the rigging because I had the best climbing when we were being tested.
Yeah.
Though I'm not that good at climbing,
Then, like I said, the cook's mate, runner, and I think everybody else basically gets assigned swab at that point in time.
I have no clue. Why is that?
I'm a swabber.
Yeah, that's what I was.
Just really quickly, I'm going to make myself a coffee.
All righty, no problem. Yeah, it's real late for. Yep, Amity is a runner. Yep, our druid is a runner as well. That's correct.
I can't edit my character sheet for some reason. I think we gained a level, if I remember right, the last time.
Yeah, you guys. Let me see, let me look at the.
I'm still level one, so.
Yeah,
the only thing. Only thing that it will let me change is the bio and the name.
Oh. That's weird. Okay. Let's see. Which one is you, Ray?
R. Fontia Zatico. Put some points into climb. I don't understand why it's showing minus one, because that just. I think it's figuring something
Wait.
Out.
Factoring in the weight. Okay. I don't understand why you wouldn't be able to edit.
I click on edit and it just goes to the character sheet and I can't get anything else.
Okay. Close that. Click on the character sheet. Can you see the character sheet?
Yeah, that's what I'm looking at. I click on edit and it goes right back to the name and bio.
Oh, no. You don't need to hit the edit. You should have editing capabilities already on the sheet.
Nope.
I'm back.
I can't do it.
On the character sheet, can you change it? Can you modify the ranks at all?
Nope. I can't do anything on the character sheet.
Yeah, that's the only thing I can't do is change my level or my class, but everything else is fine.
It gives me a show hide options, but if I go to the actual skills and stuff and the ranks.
I remember we were gonna level me up, Dave, and then you had your heart attack.
There we go. Now it's letting me.
So I guess we can do that after this session.
Oh, how many skill points does a Slayer get? Because I have to look it up.
Four. If I remember correctly. Hold on, let me look. I can look it up real quick.
Four plus int bonus, if there is one.
Let me load you up. Load up everybody here real quick. Player character. Yeah. Sorry for not being quite as all the way organized, but
okay. I'll have to do my hit. And what are my hit points?
We haven't played in like 3 months, so I think a little bit of technical difficulties this shouldn't be that big of a deal. We got to just settle right back into place where we were. It's just going to take a little time.
It's all good.
Well, since all my books are in a totally different location for where I'm at now.
Yeah. Okay. I'm waiting for Hero Labs to get its butt together so I can load. Okay. Yeah, we could do this one. Come on! What the heck? Oh, responding there. No, not there.
Yes.
There we go.
Windows okay. Doesn't like what you're doing.
two more.
Sounds so friendly, but we know that's the warning.
While I am bringing this up, I posted something in the under my Discord under the pirate. Channel of the tasks you can do during the day and during the evening.
There it is.
And
I'll repost it.
Yeah. So that's fine. Yeah, everybody's got a problem with changing the level too. That's why I'm trying to figure out where it's a configuration piece on character, and I'm trying to find. Oh, it's under configuration. Guys, to change your level on the character sheet, on the character sheet piece, go. There's four tabs. This is main, additional, spells, and configuration. You change it on the configuration page.
Right there.
Oh, there it is. See it.
And then you, yeah. Kevin's got it. I just looked at 10 minutes.
Well, I don't have a spells page, but I assume that's because I'm a rogue.
That is correct. You would not have a spells page because only those that can cast spells have a spells page.
You're saying I'm not cool?
No, you just don't have spells yet.
I'm not cool. Dang it to me.
Okay, is there something you click on after you change your level, or?
Should be just click back on the main. It should just automatically save it. I understand.
Let's see,
I'm gonna pop up. Okay, this is, for example, this is Fluffy. Yeah, you just change it and then.
Does it automatically do hit points or?
No, it will not automatically, but it does tell you what the dice is if you look under configuration.
Yeah. Under configuration.
We can roll those in front of everybody.
Roll for strength.
More like roll for hit points and roll a damn one. That's what I always.
I let you reroll ones.
Not seeing how to do.
Yeah, and I rerolled worse if I remember correctly.
Alright.
Not seeing it.
For what?
D10. I found it. It's level hit dice.
Right.
We decided we were going to put my health up the other way.
D10. Okay.
Yeah.
Roll. Oops.
Yeah, you can always take the. You can always, instead of rolling, take the average. Right. That's all. Okay.
Hey, Dave, random question.
Yeah.
My charisma modifier says -1, so if I rolled charisma, and it would take away 1 from the final score, whatever that is, right?
That is correct.
Okay. All right, cool. I'm good.
Yep, because you are not a very charismatic rogue.
That was never funny.
Now, funny is the bard over there.
What?
All right. Okay, so I want to make sure we got everything okay. So, let us... Let's see, I want to go to that. So, we only have to do that.
Okay, now there's a button that you click that apply encumbrance, armor encumbrance. Okay, got you. I guess it's doing the same thing on acrobatics.
Okay, yes, so the first, we only really honestly got past the first day on the ship, as I recall. Because basically we had the guy who got keelhauled, right? I think, was that what we're doing? Or was that the last thing that we had happen? And after you guys got assigned your position?
Yeah, I remember that. And there was also my friend.
Yeah.
Yeah. So we got assigned positions, but then I don't think we ever figured out how we ended up there in the first place.
In the position, do you mean? Or?
Yeah, well, on the ship.
Oh, no, you still haven't figured out yet how you got on the ship.
Yeah.
We were sold into slavery.
I don't accept that. There's got to be a deeper answer.
Actually, I don't think it's so much as being sold into slavery as opposed to being impressed into duty.
Yeah, it was closer.
Either way, I blame the British.
All you need to do is call 555-5555 for Judas's slave services. Call now, 40 silver ahead.
All right. So let's pack up the scenario a little bit again. There are approximately 30 pirates total, not including you guys, on this ship, of which 10 of which are basically the officers of the ship and basically ignoring you guys for the most part. Basically, the primary officers that deal with you guys, like I have said, is Mr. Plug and Master Scourge, who are giant assholes. You've already figured this one out.
Mm-hmm.
You also know that Barnabas Harrigan is not a nice guy by any stretch of the imagination. There are other people on board the ship. Of course, there's also that you... Now, Fluffy, because Fluffy's not here... Yep. Because Fluffy's not here... I already kind of know where Fluffy, because he's in a different area from the rest of you guys, can negotiate with some different people and, you know, talk to different people and stuff. So I'm just going to play him out in his area for now. Sume he was pretty much a swab, so we'll just keep him, you know, in the same position and not worry about it. So it's going to be day two. There is the list of things you can do during the day. So let me quit, because I wish I was able to just run through this and just speed it all the way up. Unfortunately, there's things that break this up. So I've got to do it a little differently than I was hoping. Let me do this.
Welcome aboard.
J-Log's been saying hi in the channel.
Oh, J-Log, I'm sorry.
APCS followed.
Thank you. Thank you very much. I can't really see anything at the moment. That's why my... All right. Let us go through real quick. First things first. I would like everybody here to make a fortitude save.
Fortitude save. Oh, fortitude check. Press the button.
Yes.
Pressed.
Yep.
Oh, I did very well.
Why did I do escape artist?
Wow.
I click on fortitude and I get escape artist.
Look at the short man over here. Look what he's doing.
Mine isn't doing fortitude for some reason. There it did. So, yeah. Can I take the escape artist role instead?
Dave, quick question.
Yes.
So, on the first day, I became fatigued. I would have had to have gone to bed early. Does that mean the fatigue is removed?
Yes. Yes, going to bed early will automatically remove fatigue. When you fail your role, when you fail your profession check. This check, however, is very, when you wake up in the morning of the second day, all of you are bright, shiny, happy, except for Amity.
Amity? I'm not feeling very well.
You hit it exact, you actually hit the target number.
Oh. I'm still not feeling very well.
It's because there are no trees.
That's right. There are no trees. There's no land. There's no birds. There's no deer.
Our tiefling is not used to being on the water.
She ain't the only one.
And is just a bit woozy from seasickness. And yes, this does affect your roll for the day, so that's why I need to roll that first. Right.
Don't mind me, I'm exhausted from heat exposure.
Okay. Ray, you are a rigger.
Yeah, I guess.
Okay. Let's go through you first, so we could just run through this as fast, as quick as we can. You are going to be assigned to repair the rigging today.
Do I get any training for this?
Okay, so the action that you want to do during the day, You can do one of these things. You can work diligently, which gives you a bonus to your rolls, to make your rolls. You can Attempt to influence a crew member.
I'll try to influence a crew member because I'm going to need to know how to rig a cell.
Gotcha. The other things that you could do is sneak around the ship. You could go to the shop and try to get your equipment back or buy something. You could, yeah, that's pretty much the ideas that you can do. All right, so you're going to try to influence somebody. Okay, so you're going to, while you are up in the rigging, let's go ahead and make your roll. It's a climb check. A problem there. And now I know you do not have proficient sailor at the moment.
No.
So roll a dexterity check.
Dex. Woohoo.
Okay.
Can you wait, guys, just a few minutes?
Woof. Yeah. I know the dog was the dogs. Okay.
I'm getting pawed right now.
Ah, gotcha. Unfortunately, your attempts to repair the rigging do not go well. And you become fatigued. Which gives you penalties until you're not fatigued. One of the riggers up there is a man known as Crimson Cogsworth. He wears a red shirt, sunburns easily, which is why he's got a red neck. And he's a human.
Sounds like he's English to me.
But he also wears a red silk pirate do-rag, basically. Try to bring him up here real quick. Like I said, he's a human. But he's one of the fellow riggers. He kind of is watching you try to repair the rigging. He's like, no, 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 that's not the way it's supposed to work. You need to do, like, you know, do the rope work like this. And he starts showing you how to do the ropes, right?
So these are called ropes. Okay, I'm familiar with ropes. It's just not...
Well, remember, rigging is the crisscross ropes.
Yeah. So. Just not used to them being crisscross. And
he kind of looks at you. So you're an elf, huh?
Yeah, I'm an elf. From Melky.
Ah.
In the forest of somewhere.
Yep. Yeah, we'll worry about that shit later. It says, yeah, I was an archer once myself. I got tired of it and decided to become a sailor.
And what influenced you to become a sailor?
I'd rather the
fresh breeze, and
I just preferred being out on the water versus being, you see your enemies a lot longer ways away.
Yeah. But there are benefits being able to hide behind a tree.
Make a perception check, right? Real quick.
Perception. Oops, that one. A few more minutes.
You notice the scarf that he has over his head is actually hiding the fact that his ear has been torn off.
So, do you mind if I ask you a question? You know, somewhat of a curious nature?
What is that?
How'd you lose your ear?
Got it bit off in a bar fight.
Oh, yeah. I can understand that, I guess. What's a bar?
He starts laughing. I see that you have no inkling of civilization. How did you get here?
I'm very well acquainted with civilization.
Yes. Elven civilization. So I assume you're from Men-Saloon? Selene, sorry. Wrong name. Selene.
I don't really, not familiar with your geography, sorry.
Understand.
You probably call where I'm from something different from what we call it.
I understand.
We're somewhat secluded in the forest.
So did you get into many fights there? You're shooting your arrows into the eyes of your opponents and having bleed out in a gory fashion.
Well, not so much in the Elven Lands, but I did receive a lot of training in the Elven Lands. And when I reached maturity, I got married, had a child, and now I'm out adventuring, and that's to gain further skills and to return back one day to my land as a trained and keen slayer.
Oh, yes, well, when we do get into a battle, just remember, give them a little extra twist of the knife. It always is a good thing.
Well, I did. I have claimed a couple trophies since I've been out. But I sent them back to my wife to show her my success as a fighter.
I see. Well, we'll see, hopefully, your prowess at that soon.
I'm fairly skilled with a bow. In fact, I can also teach people how to use a bow and arrow.
Oh, I don't need to be taught. I have one. I am an expert at the bow of my own right. So,
It would be good to help. We can train one another. Test our skills.
Well, considering, and he's motioning with his hand down because you guys are above everybody, 30 feet above everybody. He says, all of these poor swabs probably couldn't pull one of these bows back that we use. But, it might be a good thing having a bow-trained crew.
It would be helpful because, as you said, it's better to hit them before they reach you than when they're...
And on the sea, you can see them such a long ways away unless the fog is right up on top of you. It's an advantage for us... For those of us like ourselves.
And I do have some skill in bowing and fletching.
Excellent. Excellent. Hey, that would be... I will show you... Tonight, I can show you... I will show you what I have for such things.
All skills that you can teach me, I'm willing to learn. Fairly new to the adventuring life.
Okay. So we leave that conversation.
and I'm going to go let the dogs out before they complain anymore.
Yeah, before they do anything stupid. All right, so we're going to go to the next person. It will be... Let's go with Mr. Tobin. Tobin. What? Or I should say Alora. You are you roll on that table. Let me go.
I rolled an 18.
Oh no, that was for the not being sick. But I need to roll here. It's okay. They have you hauling rope today. Hauling around rope. Simple.
All right.
Simple task.
All right. Alora will work diligently.
Okay. She will work diligent. So therefore, you will make a strength check.
Okay.
Excellent roll. And then also make a constitution check.
Okay. That's going to be the big one.
Yeah, luckily you got a bonus because you're beating the strength check by so much. You are not fatigued at the end of your work shift. However, you work very diligently and ably on this. Next will be the poor person who is being a little green, which is really kind of strange considering she's already a different color. Timid. Mm-hmm.
I got that one.
just to add to the fact that Timid is already sick, they decided to put you in bilges today instead of running.
Yay.
Yeah, so this is a strength check to clean out the bilges. By the way, the bilges is all the gunk and crap and that accumulates in basically the water purification system. Give an idea. So it is a strength. Okay.
Ouch.
Well,
at least it's not a one.
It was a one, Joe.
What?
Well, did she die? Is the question.
She had a bonus on it, a plus one. So that was a one.
Oh, you mean minus one?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah. She rolled a one. Whenever it comes up, with the number is red, it's because the number is one. Rolled a one.
Oh, I got you. Okay. Oh, yeah. She rolled a one and then the bonus gave her a two.
Yeah. Timid.
Oh, that's messed up.
Timid is. Timid is going to be bedridden for the night for obvious reasons because of this. Go ahead and rule a constitution change. Check, even though we all know that it's going to. You've got so many minuses for the next day, Tim. And I'm so sorry.
How much you want to bet she rolls another one?
If she rolls another one, we're...
Yeah, this is not your environment. That's for damn sure. You're a rolling constitution. You already have a penalty on it because of your fatigue, because of your seasickness. Okay, well, at least you made that. So you're not fully sick, but you are dead-ass tired. The only way to put it. Dead-ass tired. Okay, Joe, let's do you next.
All right.
You are a swab as well.
Arr.
Hey, you got to be the runner today.
Yay. I mean, is that good?
Well, it is. That means you're running back and forth to between the crew and officers relaying orders. Do you have the run feet? No. So I already know that. You do not have the run feet. I need you to make it.
Calluses.
Yeah, well, and you're a dwarf. That's a dwarf doing the running. No, they can't have the tall people do it. Now we got to have the short dude run it.
They're testing my integrity.
That's what it is. Okay, so are you going to work diligently or talk to somebody or try to talk to the shopkeeper, the quartermaster, or try to sneak off and investigate an area?
According to the map, where are we on the ship right now?
Usually you're on the main deck when you're doing the swab. And when you're doing the running, you're okay. Running back and forth between A4 and A5, basically.
Oh, so one end of the ship to the other.
Yeah. That's what a runner is you're running back and forth giving instructions. Okay. So.
Well, I would say for now, I wouldn't do anything yet. Other than probably my regular job, because I'm more like surveying the scene around me, trying to figure out what I can do.
Okay, fair enough. Okay, so I can either call that work. Let's do that as work diligently then for this round. Okay, so let's roll a acrobatics check.
Oh God! Oh wait, acrobatics are good.
You're a thief. You should be. Oh, holy shit!
Oh my. Okay. What did I do?
Okay. Holy. So as you're running back and forth between the ship, parts of the ship, you're not only running really well on this wet, you know, kind of slimy, damp deck, because I mean, it's water makes it that way. But you're able to do cartwheels. You're doing barrel rolls. You're just making this. You're making this an exercise. You're making this a P90 workout.
Heck yeah! I just did one of those yesterday.
So you are perfectly clear. You don't even need to worry about constitution checks or anything. You are fine. You are in great shape.
Yay!
Last but not least is Mira. Mira, you were also in this lovely category. Everybody was in this category except for Ray and Fluffy. So, all right, you are down in the bilges.
Yay.
Well, we have to put the cute one down in the bilges. We have to put the strange one down in the bilges. The strange one that's sick down in the bilges. So you're down there with Timid.
Throw one on deck. See how it is.
Yep.
And the quiet one carries rope everywhere.
Yep, and the quiet one carries rope everywhere. I already know one thing you're going to be. I know you're going to be influencing. So let's roll this.
No.
You're not?
That was sarcasm.
I knew it was. Okay. You're the bard. Of course you're going to do influencing. And I know who you're going for first, too. All right. So we're going to do the strength check first.
If I can find
it. Yeah, if you can find it.
Set your timers, I'm back.
Yay. Okay, roll a constitution check. Let's see what happens. Okay, so basically everybody who's failed their checks, which has been Timid.
Arrgh.
you know, Ray and Lumu. And you're fatigued as well, Mira. So the three of you, the only, okay, let me see. Okay, Ray gets a verbal reprimand for failing. Mira gets a verbal reprimand for failing. Timid! I'm sorry. I really am sorry. But there's a reason why he's called Master Scourge.
Oh, gosh.
You get, because you failed by so much with the bilges, you get 3 lashes from the Scourge.
Is there anything I could do to help her from that?
You're not at the same location that she is. She's actually under the deck, so you don't see it.
Oh, I should have snuck.
Is there anything I can do?
Yes, you may, because you're part. You were there as well. What would you? Would you like to try to do something to block that? Because
yes, charm person.
All right, what's my target?
Master Scourge.
No. What's my DC?
Sorry, I'm not used to it working like that. Hang on a
moment. Okay, so it's your charisma buff, so
14.
Okay.
Plus 3 plus 10 in it.
Yeah. 3 plus 10 plus your level. No. Plus level spell. So it's 1. So
14.
14. Okay.
Oh, hang on. If it's plus levels, it would be plus 2, wouldn't it? So it would be 15.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Master Scourge is going to attempts to come up and has out the Scourge and is going to strike at you, Timid, but all of a sudden he kind of stops and what are you saying to him?
Hang on a moment. I just want to read what it does because it's been a while since I've.
You are going to get on his bad side. That's all I'm going to tell you for doing this.
Oh, yeah, I know that's a thing.
Oh, it matters very soon that you're on the bad side. I was actually assuming Sume was going to get on his bad side first, but you have now accomplished it.
So I'm just going to be like, you don't want to do this. You want to run around on the main deck naked.
No, you can't do. No, the charm person doesn't do that. It isn't quite that.
Stab him with a squeaky toy.
No. That's domination. That's a much higher spell.
Oh, is it? Okay, I'm probably getting this confused with.
Okay, charm person. Charm person makes him friendly and unlikely to do things. So he's going.
Okay.
So he's going to be. At the moment, he's going to be friendly. He's going to put away the Scourge, and he says. And to you, Timid, instead of striking you, he says, do better next time. And he's kind of got like a glaze over his eyes, and he wanders off. That's basically what you get him to do. So, yes, Mira has saved the day on that.
Yeah, I would like to tell him just to leave us alone, because it says you can try to give the subject orders.
He will leave you alone.
Charisma check.
Yeah, he will leave you alone for the day.
Cool.
All right. So, got that. All right. Now, would somebody please like to roll a d20 for Fluffy? Real quick.
I've been doing pretty well. You want me to do it, guys?
Go ahead.
Just a d20?
Yeah, just roll a d20 for Fluffy.
Okay, so it's roll 1d20?
Yeah.
Yeah. Roll slash d20, I think.
Okay, well, that's okay. So...
it joins the failure.
No, that, I just wanted to... that was a roll... he actually succeeded in his role.
Actually, that might not count because that was under the wrong name.
No, Fluffy has a +3 on that check, so he made it. So that's why.
Oh, dang.
But, okay. So when you guys... okay, wait a minute. Mary, you still can do your influence. And let me guess who you're going for.
Bard. Yeah, the gnome.
The bard.
Just going to be like... just, flirty, but without saying anything, you know, just being a bit of a cock tease, basically.
Well, you're going to get his... he's going to be definitely... he's going to definitely respond to that. Because he is a ladies' man. And he's not caring what race. So he is
it's all right because we're about the same height anyway, so you know.
Yeah. So he will definitely be making keeping eye on you. Well, of course he's got a patch on one eye, but I need to get a picture of him because the picture that they got of him is just amazingly.
I'm just imagining Big Boss, so you know.
He's got a black mustache where the ends of the mustache do the curl. And he's got this big purple hat with this big flower on it. He wears purple. Purple and gold is his colors. So
you're saying he's a lost tourist.
He looks, if he had the dangles from the dangle balls from his hat, he would look like Zorro the Gayblade. If you ever saw that movie. All right. So, he is definitely. Definitely reacts.
Program complete. Enter when ready.
Somebody hosted. So.
It was Egril.
Alrighty. Thank you, Egril. Yeah, I wish... I really wish I had another monitor up here. It would make my life so much easier, but I don't have the room. Alright, so. That evening, you have a meal, and the meal is fish, of course, and it actually tastes pretty good. And there's a lot of comments about this. Wait a minute, why is this actually a decent meal?
Because you're all going to die tomorrow.
Let's put it this way. Read this down. Cooking. Assisting Ambrose crew, fish guts, in preparing the day's meal. If crew is sober, no check is required. If he's drunk, it required a check. So that's why you roll, Joe.
Oh, okay.
And because he passed the check, it's actually pretty darn good food.
Ah, so we basically just barely made it.
Yeah.
All right.
So now, the evening. Those that are fatigued, I suggest heavily sleeping early to get rid of that fatigue.
Do
You don't have to. You can sneak around the ship. You can do a. You can try to steal from another pirate, which I would suggest against. Or you can entertain. Hint. To Mira, although.
Don't know what you're talking about.
Or you can. Again, you can attempt to influence a person or talk to one of the crew members. Yeah. And I thought that would be what you would do, Tim. And yeah, that it's the best thing for your character. Definitely that.
Yeah, I think I'm going to find a nice dark corner. And
well, you guys do get, you guys do have hammocks.
Like I said, I think I'll find a nice dark corner somewhere with a blanket.
The person, the people that because Tobin made it and Joe made it, and but Mira, you failed. But there's the entertain.
Yeah, Yolore is going to try to find somebody to talk to about and try to convert them over to. To her god, if possible. She's going Mormon.
All right, she's going Mormon. Give me a d20.
Just me give you a d20.
Roll a d20. Roll a d20.
Ooh. 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 Ooh.
Oh, Lou is good. Okay. If you want to. Well, he's going to be occupied. I can't use it. So. Her. You sit down next to one of the pirates. It is a female pirate.
Okay.
Second line. Sorry, I had to keep kind of scrolling back and forth. They didn't put everything. I wish they would have. I just want to see if there's any things. Oh, okay. She is a female human. And she does not wear shoes. And her name is Barefoot Sam's Toppin.
That name.
Yep. Oh, hello there.
Alora will nod to her and greet her.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. You're a cleric. How did you get on board?
I was taken.
Ah.
So I'd rather be helping the poor.
I understand. So they drugged you too.
Alora will shrug.
Unfortunately, the captain is very. He uses a special extract that he spikes drinks. His people spike drinks, and when they are drugged, they are brought on board and forced to become part of the crew. There is a number of people here that's how
they look at her and say, "But I only drink water."
Works in water. Very, very, very potent drug.
Did the chapel members betray me then?
It is. If that's where you were, I would suspect some of the poor that were paid. It's how I came on board. How I became part of the crew. Now you're Cuthbert, right?
Yeah, she's her goddess Cuthbert, I think. The one that punches people and hits them with big sticks.
Yeah, that's good. The cudgel.
Ah, yes. Jim Hayes character. Ray remembers that. And his attempts at orc interrogation.
I remember Jim Hay interrogating a pigeon, a chicken, and two other animals as well.
Yeah, but that was in my campaign. That wasn't the Living Greyhawk, which is where he tried to interrogate the orcs and Bevert was giving him the wrong translations. Anyways, fun in our old campaigns. All right, so she goes, well, I am glad a cleric is here. She kind of motions out and. Because, I mean, everybody's kind of in a gathered area, and she says, you know, Sandera is a cleric. She's pretty much the only other cleric on board the ship.
Alora will rub her chin and say, yes, many on this ship need salvation, and many more, and she'll go quiet.
Mm-hmm. He says, yes, many on the ship are consumed with their own needs and wish to harm others. There's a few of us, though, that still care for people. You got the right person, by the way.
I got the right person.
You got one of the good. You got one of the characters that's actually good. Good aligned. So they need to be. I agree with you. They need to be shown a better path.
Okay. Alora will say, yeah, if it wasn't for Cuthbert, I wouldn't have had my path.
I am not a very religious person at the moment, but I do feel that we should help as many people as possible. We should not be harming them like we are here.
Alora will, you know, nod silently.
All right. Joe.
What's up?
Okay. Now, you can participate in this wonderful, fun excitement by either doing gambling or you can. I don't think you'll be performing. Or you can go off and search a part of the ship, if you wish.
I don't know, man. I was a pretty good performer about 20 years ago. I'd say probably for my character, since I did my job very well, I'm not fatigued right now.
Mm-hmm.
I would probably go search a part of the ship.
Okay. So you know here, the It's primarily, you know, the galley, the cargo areas, the... I don't think you really want to search the bilges. You know, the various storerooms and things like that. So, let us roll a... All right, so it is first a stealth check.
Okay.
Which you are the thief, therefore it is pretty much gonna. If you fail this, I'd be. Let's.
I just got a 7 plus 8, so I got a 15.
Yep. All right. So let me find.
That bonus, man.
Yep. All right. Where's the book? All right. Mm-hmm. Sorry, look this up real quick. As you're searching around in the cargo area, you first find one thing. You find a discarded cutlass.
Okay.
That you were able to take. The other thing you find is, while you were down there, there is a the main mast, the main pole pillar of the cargo area. There is a 7 foot tall human, dark skinned man that is chained to it.
Wow.
As you look, go ahead and make a perception check.
Okay.
Ty Perceptive, is that you?
You think his left eye looks strange as well. And he seems to be just, like I said, chained to this, he's kind of, you know, he's not really reacting to you. He's just kind of sullen, kind of, you know, not very active at the moment. And he just... The guy looks like he's beefy as hell, though, I will say that. But he is a human. Not anything, any sort of strange race or anything, but he is.
Okay, so he is awake and he's looking at me then.
Yeah, he is, but you can tell one of his eyes isn't quite right.
Okay.
Who are you?
No, I wonder.
Who are you?
I could talk back to him and say, I'm K-Rom. Who are you?
The Owl Bear.
Say it again?
Owl Bear.
Owl Bear?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, got it. Can I ask him why is he down here chained up to the mast?
Albert, get hurt.
Albert, get hurt?
Get hurt.
Get hurt. Okay.
Now, everybody who's ever seen Blazing Saddles may now realize who this character is. The equivalent of.
I gotta watch that sometime if I've ever seen it.
But!
No, I'm gonna get yelled at, dude. I've heard the term a million times. I've never watched it.
So don't feel alone.
I'm not alone!
We're gonna stick it. We're gonna stick you guys. We're gonna stick you guys on in front of a television.
Oh, gosh.
Yes, Timid, it is exactly that.
Mongo like candy.
I keep missing it every time it's on TV because.
Yeah, and it's always on TV. That's the sad thing about it. Yeah. Mongo crushed too much stuff. Not Mongo, but Albert. You get the idea. You get the idea.
Albert crushed too much.
Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, he's dressed in rags. He's not even, you know, he's not really dressed. Really not. I mean, they are treating him like shit. It's pretty obvious that they are treating this guy like shit. But you can also tell he is probably the strongest person on this damn ship.
Yeah. Well, what I'm wondering is, are they treating him pretty much like a slave? Is that why they have him all chained up and everything?
It's not as much of that he's a slave. It's that they're afraid of him.
So why have him on the ship at all?
Because he crushes things.
Okay.
So they let him go, he will crush them all. That's why.
Well. I know, I got that. I'm just saying, like, if they're afraid of him, why have him on the ship at all? That's all I'm trying to figure out.
Yeah.
It's almost like it was forced upon the captain as well, or whoever's his owner.
Well, you mean you can ask him? That he'll be able to answer very much. But
all right. Who puts you here,
Captain?
Captain.
Yeah.
Okay. When we
took Chip Mongo crush enemy.
Ooh.
That Mongo job. I keep saying Mongo, it's supposed to be Albert. I'm now stuck in Mongo mode.
It's all good, it's all good. I know, I got you guys stuck on Blazing Saddles. Alright. I'm not sure what I should do right now, to be honest. I'm thinking as if I don't know if I should just leave him there. I mean, he's the biggest guy there. If I unchain him, is he going to do something that I would regret?
The only thing he could do that you would regret if you let him go is when he crushes your head.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. Well, he's aware of what he's doing wrong as well.
Mm-hmm.
So,
but that isn't going to stop him from doing it again.
Yeah, of course. Well, I'm sorry.
Tim is remembering all the lines.
There's got to be a reason why he's on the ship. Other than just them being afraid of him and then just hooking him up. There's got to be more of a reason. I feel like there is.
You're not going to get the answer from him. I'll be honest with you.
Okay. All right.
Yeah, Albert/Mongo is a little too simple to give you that kind of answer.
Yeah,
yeah, that's true.
Albert has a 4-int, so he's not going to get you very much.
If I ask the question, like, why here? Right.
Mongo just pawned in. Big game of life. But the other thing, the main thing also besides finding Owlbear is the fact that, by the way, Fluffy had already found Owlbear. So,
okay.
But is finding the colors.
All right. Well, to be honest, then I think what would probably be best for now is that now that I'm aware that he's there, has Fluffy told anybody else?
No, not that I know of.
Okay.
Well, no, Fluffy, the cook and the quartermaster all know Mongo's there. Albert's there.
Yeah. Okay, what I'm thinking it would be for the best then is probably just leave the room. Leave the room and, you know, obviously be aware of it. Probably go somewhere else on the ship if I can for now, or go back to my own quarters.
Yeah. Okay. Going back to your own quarters is probably the best thing.
All right, let's do that.
Okay. Mira, you are fatigued.
Yes.
You are fatigued. Are you still going? Are you still going to try influence or entertain
or gamble? So I have a question, right? Okay. So if I go to bed early, the next day I won't have fatigue, correct? Yeah.
That is correct.
Okay. And according to this, I can only do one thing.
Right.
One thing, yeah?
Right.
This is completely up to you, obviously. Can I do entertain but only one song and then go to bed early and still get...
What it will allow you to do is that you will get a constitution check to get rid of your fatigue.
Okay, I will take that.
Okay. So go ahead and roll the entertain.
And can I do a duet with the gnome?
Yes, you may.
Thank you.
And he is a singer.
God damn it, so am I.
So, well, I mean, it's a duet. It'll work.
Yeah, but I was hoping you'd do backing, but okay.
Oh, well, he can do backing, too. He does have a... Actually, why you're talking with him about this? One of the halfling by the name of Rosie Kurzweil comes wandering up. He said, well, you know, if I had my violin, I could be backing you guys. But the captain took my violin. They've got it, and I can't get it. She's a female halfling, by the way.
Okay. Well, can you sing or dance?
I could always try.
Let's do a... I can't think of the... This is out of character. I can't think of the word for what three people doing something would be. Would that count as a band, I guess?
Well, a trio.
That's the word I wanted. Thank you. Yeah.
Or the Bee Gees, depending on which way you want to look at it. No,
I'm the one with the beard, lol.
Yeah.
I'm just going to say, yeah, fuck it. Let's do it.
All right. Okay, so we've got your...
Holy shit.
Jesus Christ. Was that a 20? Or is that 19?
That 19, dang it. We still haven't got a 20 yet. We're close.
All right, let's see. Let me go over to Conchobar. What's his performance skill here? It's... Holy shit. Okay, so I got to roll a 20...
Watch him roll a 20, and then the halfling roll a 20.
Almost! And then Rosie. Rosie, however, has no skill at this, so it's going to be probably... Let's see, I need to look at Rosie's charisma. Okay. She's still 18. Yeah, okay. You definitely entertain the troops. Oh my god.
The song that I'm singing is Yar Har Fiddly Dee, You Are a Pirate.
It's the pirate for me.
No, no, no. That's the song from, what was it?
Lazy Town.
Yeah, Lazy Town. Yeah, the Lazy Town.
You wanted me to make something
from Muppet Treasure Island.
I can't remember any of the songs from that.
Yeah. I want to see what this does. Hold on one second. Jump down.
Well, it only convinces half the crew to join us in our future revolution.
Okay. No, I didn't. Your ability to negotiate, to influence Mira from this point on, you have a bonus with the crew.
Wait.
So you have.
Do you want me to make a note of this, or shall you?
No, you go ahead.
Okay.
So all of your chances to influence are now improved because of how well you performed.
Yay!
Okay.
And you wanted me to make a con check, didn't you?
Yeah, so you want, you make a con check, yeah. Oh, yeah, okay, so you will not be fatigued. Next day. All right, next morning. Timon needs to make a con check. Yeah, this is so you aren't seasick again.
If Timon rolls another one,
okay. This day you are able to not be as green when you get up. As you guys are going up to be assigned your duties for the day. As you approach the stairs, four pirates are standing there, blocking your way.
In a hurry to go somewhere?
I don't know, you don't seem to be.
Oh, the captain, Mr. Plume doesn't like you.
Your little lot of people.
It's the Malfoy of pirates. Oh, God. Oh, God.
Yeah. So let us...
we're going to make sure that you're late to work. And Mr. Plug will then have a excuse to have you flogged.
Are we all here?
You are all here.
Okay, I'm just going to say to them, you know, if you make us late, I won't perform like I did again last night.
I don't really care. And of course, they're cracking knuckles at this point in time. Yes, you are. Ooh. With them.
Ooh, big, strong men must show your worth.
Oh, no, you're not with them. Okay, you're saying that's the pirate. I'm sorry. It's just... No, it doesn't matter. He doesn't like you either. So they're cracking knuckles right now. Do you guys want to roll initiatives? Yes, we actually get a combat!
Yay, combat.
It's a fist fight, though.
Yeah.
Am I here right now?
You are all here.
Okay.
You're all trying to report for duty on top of the ship and get your assignments.
Okay.
Jesus. 19.
Yep.
Where are these numbers coming from?
Tobin, do you want to go first?
If nobody else beats me, sure. Considering I've got the highest constitution out of anybody here, yeah, I should be tanking this shit.
I should roll for initiative, too.
Yes. Everybody rolls for initiative.
Yeah, you can go first, Tobin. Does it work the same like that? If people tie, you get to choose who goes first?
Okay. Yep. Yes. That's normally what happens. Okay. Kevin?
Yeah. Me and James have decided that I'm going first because I've got the highest hit points and constitution out of the two of us.
Yep.
All right. I'm going to be tanking shots.
Okay, hold on a second. Let me do mine.
Did mine show up?
I'm actually going to ask you to do something for me out of
character. No.
Okay, it says you wanted to send the result of this roll to the turn tracker, but no valid token was selected.
Laura shows. Let's see. I see mirror. Laura.
Yeah, I saw the 14. Why don't I see?
Yeah, I see yours, Tim, and mine was a 16.
Okay, I'll. That's fine.
Okay.
I'll show you.
Okay, Simon sees it.
Okay. All right. Oh, no, I see it. I'm a brain dead idiot. Okay.
I was just wondering why it popped up with a message like it did.
Okay, you're going to love how this works. But, good. Okay. All right, let me say, Timid, if you want to use your psi, you can, but you're pulling a weapon, a lethal weapon. So killing a crew member means you get keel hauled, just so you remember, you know that. Which will be fatal.
He was like, oh, I'm going to rethink this.
You can brandish a weapon, though, and see what...
Are there any things that could be used as weapons, like a peg?
You could theoretically, yes, you could find you could use an improvised weapon as a club. Yes. Basically, you need to declare
all the weapons she needs in her left and right fist.
Yeah, and all of these guys are unarmed. You do not see any. They are not. Don't have weapons out. Yes, you can use the system.
How many of them are there?
There's four of them.
Four. Okay.
Okay. You still would be pulling out the Sith, though. Just so you know, you're pulling out the Sith. Okay. Got it. All right. That'll be effective on your turn, then. So... All right. So, Alora, you are going first. You have a 21.
Yes, I am. Okay. You attack the first person that is closest to her.
Okay.
Fist.
All right.
My melee, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Okay. 13.
13, they are not armored. And they do not have any dexterity worth a damn, so yes, you hit. It is 1d3 adjusted by your strength.
There is no 1d3 on the basic roll.
D6 divided by 2.
Alright, I'll roll a 1d6 then. 1d6 adjusted by what?
Strength. Strength modifier.
All right, so it'd be 1d6 plus 2.
Let me get this set up. Come on. 1d6 plus.
It's a heck of a lot easier with the program and I have to do everything by hand.
I should do a 1d3. Let's check it.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, so you slug the guy.
I'll do 1d6 for simplicity's sake if you don't mind.
That's fine.
All right, thank you very much.
Okay, Mira, you're up. You've cut. Okay, you clock him one. Like, eh? Mira.
Sorry, I forgot to push, hold down, push to talk. So I was talking to myself for a minute then. These guys, how much distance is in between each one?
They're at they're blocking the steps, so they're right next to one another.
Right. Okay, can I cast Grease and make sure I don't get, I forget the character's name, Allura?
Yes. It? Yes, you may. It's going to be fine. Okay. I get to make dexterity checks. Yeah.
Which is, if I click it, it should all come up, shouldn't it?
Mm-hmm. Nice. Okay. And let me look at my. I know I don't have. Successful reflex. Okay. The pirate that Allura punched immediately falls on his ass.
Hey. And I would like to jump back 5 feet and then end my turn.
Okay. Okay, so basically what happens is this, the one Allura punched falls down. The one next to him stays up. Third one falls down. Fourth one stays up. The two have fallen on the foot.
Let's see.
Okay. Next one is Ray. And from what I can tell.
Okay, there's two still standing at the top of the stairs.
There's two. They're at the bottom of the stairs, actually. It's where you're
at the bottom of the stairs. Oh, they're at the bottom. Okay.
And they're blocking you. But two have fallen down.
Well, sort of they're blocking us.
Yeah.
Until I do one of my idioms and go running, jump on Laura's shoulders, and try to leap over, doing an acrobatic move to get behind them.
All right, you may roll your acrobatics to do that.
All right, if he succeed.
Oh, yes.
All right.
Now, make another acrobatics.
We'll note that up.
Take a second acrobatics.
His character will note that up. Laura, as he lifts himself over her, stiffens up as if she's expecting him.
You land, you do not fall because you're in the grease spell now. So you planted the landing even in the grease spell. You may now make your attack. An attack.
Alright, I'm just going to smack one. Base attack on a roll is that, so roll slash roll d20 roll plus one Try that.
All right, you hit them. You're not a rogue, right? Oh no, you're a slayer. You do get that. Yeah, never mind. Okay, you get sneak attack bonus on your on the dice as well.
Since it's an improvised club, what would the damage
it's
be?
It's 1d6.
1d6.
Clubs are always 1d6. And so, and then you have one sneak attack die.
Yeah, that, what is,
so, which is another d6, yeah.
Okay. So it'll be 2d6.
Yep. Are you?
Well, at least you didn't roll one.
One of the ones that's standing up, or the guy that fell, one of the ones that fell down?
One's standing up.
Got it. And what's your strength, right?
Oh, I got that'd be so total be 6 because I have a strength of 1. So
I forgot that. One. Oh, strength of 1 be 5. You don't get the bonus on the. So at a 5. All right. Okay. Let me lull. Supposed to. Okay, the one that fell down that Alora hit scrambles and stands up. However, because of that, and because of the grease spell, and the fact that he has to make an acrobatics check to get up and everything else by that, Alora, you may make another swing. Called an attack of opportunity.
All right, 1d6 plus 2, or 1d3 plus 2.
Yeah, well, you have to attack. You have to hit.
All right, let me roll my attack. My attack.
You have a bonus on this, so, I mean, there's a bonus.
Wow, impressive. Comic-Con has enough to do commercials on CW.
Oh. Okay, you've hit. Go ahead and roll your d3 plus 2. Shit. Holy crap.
Sweet. Yeah, that would have been a 5.
Yep, we got it. And I got to do this. And he falls on his ass again with that punch.
Alora will look down on him and say, don't get back up.
Next, I think, is, am I correct that it would be Joe?
Hi.
Yes, it would be. Joe.
By the way, Dave, a random Zoom wolf has appeared.
Hey!
Hey, buddy, you're an hour and 45 minutes late.
Hello.
Hello, Zoom-A. They're in a fist fight with four pirates.
20. I don't know if he's here.
Yeah, he's here.
Yeah, he's in Twitch. He's not in the call. There he is.
There he is.
Hey, buddy, you're late.
Yeah, I know.
That's all right. You're here. And they're in a fist fight.
I'm just messing with them.
And they're in a fist fight. And now the guy who fights naturally with his fists just showed up.
And now they're really fucked.
Yeah, now they're really fucked.
Yes.
This is super. This is all right. So Joe, go ahead. There's four there. There are two still on their butts, and two still standing.
Okay. Well, I suck at intimidation, so I'm not going to try anything with that.
Okay.
Which two are still up?
The one that Ray hit, and one that's not been hit at all.
I mean, like you said, they were all four lined up together blocking.
Number two and four are standing as you look at them.
I'll walk up to two. And I'll give him like one really big punch to the stomach.
All right.
Okay, so what should I roll for?
Okay, it would be a... You roll 1d20 plus your rogue, so you would have plus one. Plus, what is your... Do you have a strength modifier?
Let me see one sec. Yeah, one.
Okay, so it'd be a 1d20 plus two.
Plus two. I think I did that right. There you go. 14.
All right. You hit him. So now the damage would be 1d3 plus one.
Okay.
And you could either do a d6 and divide it in half.
I'll do 1d3 plus one. Four.
I'll check the timer. Dog wants out.
All right. All right, so now I gotta hit. Now I roll this again. When you hit him in the gut, that's the one that Ray hit in the back. When you hit him in the gut, he drops to his knees.
Nice.
All right. It is now Tibbet's turn. There's one that's standing, one that's still on the ground. He hasn't had a chance to get up. One's on his knees and the other one's on the ground.
One and three are on the ground, two's on his knees, and four is still standing.
Yep.
All right.
David, also don't forget what else you have.
To be honest, for my turn, I was thinking about pulling out that. Oh crap! What? Let me see what it was again. The discarded cutlass that I found downstairs.
Yeah. By the way, that is the equivalent of a short sword. It's a 1d6 damage weapon.
Yeah, but then I was like, you know what? I wasn't gonna use them to hurt anybody, but I was gonna use it as intimidation. But I looked at my intimidation cell; it was like a minus one modifier.
You're not very intimidating.
I'm good. Yeah, let's just go up and punch him in the gut. I think he'll get the message.
Yeah.
Hey, Sume, you have your character, right?
Yes.
Okay. Go ahead and Timid, go ahead and roll your attack on your scythe. What was that? Okay. That was weird.
She says she'll take her scythe and slam the butt of it into the guy of the gut, the one still standing.
Mm-hmm.
And then she did melee versus AC scythe, and it did six.
Right, so she missed, actually, with her attempt to jab him in the gut. So the damage is irrelevant. I don't know why all the D4s rolled. So, yeah, you missed with the scythe.
Yeah. Dang it.
You tried. But he dodged out of the way. He seems to be a pretty nimble guy. Now, he... says, oh, we're going to play with weapons, huh? And he flips out a dagger.
Ooh.
Look at this greaser guy.
And he will attempt to attack. Can't figure out. I have a card. This guy's an asshole, though. So this is exactly what he would do. So. He's a jackass. He attempts to flick his dagger at you, Timid, and he has about as much of a chance of hitting you as you did of him. As in, he really sucked at it.
Yeah. Him trying to keep his balance on the greasy floor.
Yeah, now he is doing a really good job of keeping his balance. compared to everybody else. But he still can't hit.
His friends all laid out.
Yeah, but he can't. Still can't hit you. Okay. So, May, you want what you walk up into at this point in time with your compatriots here. Four pirates have attempted to block the group from coming going up to the main deck for their assignments for the day. They are not faring very well. There is one on the ground, flat on the ground. There's one on his knees on the ground. The third one that is flat on the ground. The fourth one that's standing up and has a little dagger and is facing off against Timid, who's using the butt end of her scythe against him. This is what you walk up into. Timid, I don't know. Today is just not your day with the RNG.
I'll be right back. I gotta run to the restroom.
Okay.
So, okay, so there's one guy standing, right?
Yep, it's one guy standing.
Okay.
Now, I will point out that it is basically a death sentence if you actually kill somebody on the ship that's a pirate crew member. Probably don't want to kill anybody, but from that point.
And did I mute?
No, you're not mute.
Okay. Couldn't tell you if I could hear anything or not.
Okay.
Currently, I got a big dog staring at me.
I'm waiting on what Sumi wants.
Come here.
Okay. Get up. I'm going to go try and punch him in the gut.
Okay, go for it. And since you already, so going non-lethal, right? I'm assuming because you can declare yourself.
Yeah, we're gonna try.
But you still get your full damage on this, so
I'm gonna be nice. Go non-lethal.
Okay, but you still get your full damage. So go ahead and roll your attack for attacks.
Yes, let's see how long this guy keeps standing.
Probably not very long, but I think. Yeah. 21. Ow. Okay, roll your damage.
And I have no idea how to do that.
Hold on a second.
What have you been eating?
Squirrels, rabbits, my own poo.
The last one is probably high.
much higher chance, yeah.
And yeah, rabbit won't stand a chance. Trust me, I don't know. I haven't seen her catch a rabbit, but I saw some of her previous dogs. Rabbit tried to make a valiant dash across the yard.
Okay, Sumi, your damage is... So what's your strength?
It is... Plus 3.
Okay, so you're rolling 1d4 plus 3, and then you're rolling a second attack. Yeah, it's your claws there.
Oh, okay.
So 1d4 plus 3, you're doing it twice. Yeah. Okay. So somebody walks up to this guy, and he turns his knife to look at Zume. And then you said you were going for the gut, right?
Yeah.
One punch to the gut, and the guy drops the dagger and doubles over. The second punch ends up actually being more of an uppercut, and you clock his ass, and he goes flying backwards and back against the steps, and he's out. Completely unconscious.
Well, I think they've all been dealt with.
Yes.
And, well, if he would have used the claws, Timot, he would have ripped his guts out. So.
That would have been nice.
Yeah. So he's absolutely out. The one guy, the other guys are like, holy crap.
So anybody else want that dagger other than me?
Can I take a free action?
Yeah.
Can I take a free action to do an intimidation, or should I wait for my turn?
Oh, no. You could go do intimidation right now.
Okay. I'm just basically going to say, I think we've made our point. I think you should leave us alone.
Yeah. I think we're going to leave you alone.
Our lore will say, I had my mace, it would have been much shorter.
And you should remember that you had an accident on.
Yeah.
She'll step over the body, the pile of bodies, and get up.
As I balance the dagger in my hand.
Mm-hmm. Yep, Okay, you've got his dagger. You can slip. You can take his dagger.
Just very quickly, Dave. I'm going to go to the toilet. I'll be back.
Okay, no problem. Obviously, because you guys took him out in like two turns, you actually took him out in less than a turn. Good God. Of course, I didn't expect Sumi to show up. Sumi's character is like disgusting in this department right now. You guys go get up on the top. You make your time without any problem. The other four guys, however, end up getting the lashes because they're late, because they have to try to climb up the grease spell.
Okay, I'm back.
All right. So somebody took the guy out in two shots. And the other three are intimidated. But that was the four of the evil pirates, and you guys just handed them their ass. Okay.
As we go up the stairs, I'm just going to glare at them.
Mm-hmm.
Give them that stink eye.
I'll just continue to balance the dagger in my hand as I walk up the stairs.
Yeah, but you're probably going to want to hide it before you put it away.
I will.
Okay. It is a throwing dagger.
Okay. I'm looking. Oh, well. Not skilled in it, but.
All right. But it is, like I said, it is a throwing dagger. So. All right. So you get up on top. And you get to go through two more things, hopefully. That's six.
Welcome aboard.
Thank you for the follow. Okay. upper rigging work for Ray. So we need to make a climb check again. Well, we need to determine what you're going to be doing while you're... Are you going to try to talk to one of the other riggers or talk to...
Yeah, I'll try to talk to another rigger and ask him about the same advice, how to what's the proper way of tying these knots.
Okay, and then go ahead and roll the dex check again. Yeah. Oh, you make that roll that time. All right, I'm looking for the riggers here. Rigger. He's not a rigger. Oh, he is a rigger. Okay. Oh, he's a rigger. Let's see. He's a swamp. Sandra is a swamp. He's a rigger. Talk to him. He's a rigger. He's a rigger. He's a rigger. Well, here's your choice, Ray. You can either talk to the gnome, the foppish gnome he is a rigger. You could talk to the person that Tobin talked to that night, who's a rigger, who's running around doing all the stuff barefoot. Or the other two riggers that are available that you can talk to are the two that attempted to ambush you.
Nate. Talk to the gnome first.
All right.
Intriguing.
Hello, good fellow.
Greetings.
I am Conchavar Tulak Shortstone. At your service.
Greetings, you can call me Arg.
Arg. Yeah, interesting name.
Yeah, there's a story behind it, but I think that's true for all.
Of course. But I am a purveyor of stories. Something to keep in mind for later.
A purveyor of sorts. I'm not familiar with that profession.
Most people call that bard.
A purveyor of sorts means bard. Okay, got ya.
And so. How does an elven lad go from forests to webs of ropes?
One drinks the wrong brew and wakes up in a strange, dark place surrounded by water.
I was brought here in a very similar fashion. So I understand completely. I am glad to meet your acquaintance. May I ask you a question?
Sure.
The young lass that is with you.
How did I know?
Is she available?
That would be her decision.
It's a no from me.
it is quite a fetching young thing.
I suppose. I'm married, so I don't know. And being an elven.
Don't worry, I don't swing that direction. I am not like my cousin Scanlan. Yes. Well, I will have to. Hopefully, we'll eventually get a chance to dock at some point in time, and I will have to treat dock like that, and treat her to a meal, and get to know her better.
I guess that's however you people do that sort of thing.
Yes, of course.
What is this strange human thing you call love?
All right. Let's go down the road again. Alora!
Yes. Well, she's going to work hard during the day.
Okay. By the way, thanks, Lauren, for following.
Oh, Joey, just what we needed. Purge.
Unless she's working the bilges, she's working hard. If they set her with the bilges, she's going to be doing something else.
Yeah. By the way, that was Lauren from Omaha that followed.
Ah.
Right? You remember Lauren.
Yeah, I remember Lauren.
Okay. So, next is, okay, so I gotta keep flipping. Hey, I really wish that they would have done these pages just a bit better so I could pull this stuff up. Okay, you are doing repairs today, Alora. And you either do a profession sailor check, which I know you don't have, or a dexterity check. And you will get the verbal reprimand. However, because you do not get fatigued. This is a good thing. All right, Sume, you were a swab, were you not?
Yes.
Hey. You get to play in the bilges today. You get to clean all the gunk out of the bilges. Congratulations. Hey. All right, I want you to roll a strength check first. Oh, actually, well, let me ask you this. Okay, before we do this, I'll hold off on that for a second. You can either work diligently, sneak off, try to get your equipment, or try to influence someone as your action for the morning. What would you like to do?
I doubt I'd be able to get my equipment back because I have the worst charisma in the crew.
Right.
I was going to work.
Okay. All right. Because you've decided to work diligently, you actually make the check. That's why I wanted to make sure. Go ahead and roll the Constitution. Constitution check. Oh, Jesus. Yeah, not a problem there at all. You are definitely not fatigued cleaning out the bilges. Timid. Person who has had the worst luck in the universe on this. You are going to be swabbing the deck. Yay.
Yeah, they finally took you out of the bilges.
Yeah, the air will be fresher.
Yeah. You scrub the decks with sandstone blocks called holly stones, requiring either a strength or a constitution check. Oh, actually, yeah, yes, strength. So, strength and constitution checks. Much better! You are not fatigued, and you do it well. Are you going to be talking to anybody or yet, or sneaking away, or try? You've already got your equipment back, so. Okay, got it. All right. It is Farrah's turn.
Okay.
You are playing rat catcher.
Yay.
Okay. You either choose stealth, survival, or dexterity.
Let me have a look.
God. No, no, no. Not another RoboCop reboot. Anything but another RoboCop reboot.
By the way, they're doing another RoboCop reboot.
Yep. Didn't they do one like 5 years ago?
2013, 2014, but this one's being done by Neil Blomkamp. It's the same guy who did District 9.
I'm gonna wait.
Yeah, Tim, it actually the weasel could have attacked. It could have shown up at the fist fight as well. And that
even though he's chained up to the goddamn main mast.
So, whom can I influence?
Who can you influence? You can influence any of the swabs, which is pretty much anybody, except for the five riggers.
Okay. I'm just gonna roll a dice.
Okay.
And can we do it that way?
Yep. Roll a d20.
Just a d20?
Yep. Roll a d20. See, let's see who you get. Oh, yeah. No, he's... No, you talked him out of genie, I thought. Maybe I forgot about that. I got that backwards. I thought that you talked him out of that. Well, you don't want to talk to him. I want to re-roll that. I know it was a 20. It was just a waste of a 20 today. You know, take that back. No, let's go on with that. Hold on. Take that back. You know who you are.
Please don't be the fop.
Nope. No, Ray's already talked to the fop. Can't do that. Can't do him twice. However,
I'm sorry, Dave, but I can't do that.
However, a certain cutthroat rock, you are able to talk to, who happens to be the only half-orc on a female. It's a female half-orc, the only half-orc on this entire ship, who happens to be the quartermaster.
Oh boy!
Neat.
Neat.
So what are they doing? Oh, shit.
Oh my god, what the heck? Oh my god. Okay. So anyways, they actually come up to you. She actually comes up to you. Hey, you're a pretty good singer.
Thank you.
Yeah. How did you get started? Did you get drugged by the and brought on board?
Probably, but I'm just taking this as a holiday.
She kind of...
It's a new adventure, and it will be great for songs.
Yeah, it's sea songs, sea shanties, all sorts of interesting things. Yes. You know. I want you to make a diplomacy check.
Okay.
And you've got bonuses.
Woo. Well, I don't know what the bonus is.
Yeah. Well, your bonus is plus 4.
Nice. So that's a 28 then.
Like, tell you what. You and your friends come by the storehouse this evening. I like you guys. Come on by
okay.
Come on by the storehouse this evening, and I'll get you fixed up.
Well, thank you.
I'm looking at this character, and it says, if she's there when somebody uses perform sing, you get this much extra bonus.
I'm helpful.
You're helping.
Okay. Joe!
As a side thing, as a fluff thing, I guess, or whatever, I will let everyone know that I can find about that.
Yeah. Yeah, no, you were able to be able to tell at least all this everybody that, you've been invited to come down to the storeroom after work is over. All right, so... Joe, it is up to you. For the last of this list, at least for now.
Okay, what are my decisions right now?
Your decisions are, you do the... Am I going the wrong way? There's the damn roll that I was looking for earlier. How come you can't put it in the same spot, you damn shit? Okay. You are again a runner. How did that happen?
Dang.
I'll make you.
You must have really liked me on the first day.
Yeah. Roll your acrobatics check.
All right. Ouch.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a one.
Not very good. Splat. Well, you're going to get a reprimand for that. And then constitution check.
Okay. Ouch.
And you're going to be fatigued. So, now, did you want to... Now, here's the question, though. Did you want to work diligent, or did you want to talk to somebody, or any of that? Or sneak around again?
I'm wondering if I can sneak around and go get my stuff.
Well, you can't get. You can go and negotiate separate if you want to try. But actually, you if you sneak around, you basically can find items.
Okay. Yeah, I don't know. I don't have any clue. Well, last time I snuck around, I made it to the bottom of the ship, and I made it to the mast and saw.
Albert. Yeah.
So I wouldn't sneak around again, but maybe I would try talking to somebody, see if I can figure some stuff out.
Okay. Roll a d20.
Okay.
I'll just roll a d20.
Just a 1d20?
Yeah, just a 1d20, just straight. There's 20 people you can talk to, that's why.
There we go. 17.
All right. That one. You find a tall female human.
Okay.
Who is dark skinned. There's a place in Greyhawk that's called the Amito Jungle. And it looks like she is from that region. Looks very, the best way to describe this is kind of a Jamaican look.
Oh, Jamaican man.
Yeah. And,
okay.
He kind of looks at you, says, what do you want?
I hope you didn't mind me asking. I was basically going to find out. How did you end up here?
After my little group broke up, I decided to join Captain. I've been doing a lot of work around the jungles of Amito.
Okay, what's your name?
Shivaka.
Shivaka. All right.
Shivaka.
I gotta write that one down.
Yeah, that one's Shivikah.
I was really close. I put AKA. All right, got it.
Yes, but pirate life has suited me, and it's less dangerous than what we were doing.
Have you been having a good time on the ship ever since you've been here?
Well, just swabbing a deck, but I have not been here since we have not, I am relatively new here. Not as new as you, of course. But we've not taken on any vessels yet.
Are we
happy yes, to take on any? Yes, she soon? Has dreads. Yes, she has dreads. Okay. It depends. When we spot a ship, I'm sure that the captain will go after it. We're not ones to let prizes go, my understanding.
Okay.
You'll make a diplomacy check.
Okay.
Fluffy.
I got a 20. Baby. Yeah.
Wow.
I got a minus one and I still got a 20.
You know, I have misjudged you. You and your friends might be okay. But I don't know whether or not you would accept me in my former profession.
Oh, yeah.
What was it?
Former profession again.
We had, we kind of took people and sold them.
Oh, so a slave trader.
Yes.
All right.
But I'm no longer a slave trader. I'm now, I don't know if that's a step up or not, actually, if I think about it. But I think it is, being a pirate.
It's kind of a role reversal for you.
Yeah. Well, you know, you do it. Somebody, if I did not do it, someone else would have and made the money that I did. But I still prefer the sea.
You said that you had worked with the captain before. Was he in on it as well?
Yes, we were selling to him.
Is that how we ended up here in the first place?
You were drugged and taken here, yes. I was involved in that.
Okay.
Yes, I was. Captain has agents that are in Greyhawk, the city of Greyhawk. He has agents that are in the city of Divers. He has agents that are in the city of Realmord looking for people.
Why does he need people so badly? I mean, a ship only takes so many.
He wishes to become an admiral. He wishes to have a full fleet of ships. This is cool. That he may become powerful.
Is this the only ship that he has for now?
At the moment, yes.
Okay.
From my understanding, it's his only ship at the moment. I'm sure.
He doesn't expect people to come and work for him. He intends to take people.
Yes. Well, when you take a ship, you will. He will offer those that are survivors whether or not to join the ship or to be dumped overboard. And usually people take the prudent choice.
I think everybody would rather not die.
Especially in the middle of a deep ocean that nobody knows the depth of. Yes.
Yeah, I'm not a really good swimmer.
Most people,
short legs and arms.
You would be surprised how many people become sailors and become pirates who cannot swim. Now, when we attack a ship, to add to this, the pirate will throw chum into the water before he attacks.
How was that?
Track sharks.
Sharks.
I was thinking something like that.
People fall overboard and fall into the water, then you have to worry about sharks that are there. And then, like I said, afterwards, you throw the people overboard that don't want to join you right to the sharks.
Fast way to get rid of them.
Captain is not a nice person.
All right. Well, I'm going to say it was nice talking to you, and I better get back to work before I get in trouble.
All right. Very good.
All right. You have a good one.
Yes. Okay. Night. Evening, I should say. No one's, I think, only one person's fatigued. Well, technically, no's fatigued. But other than that, I don't think anybody else is fatigued this time. So, do you guys all go down to the quartermaster?
Yes.
And I do. And I will inform Mira Suter.
Okay. Okay. Okay, Timmy, you're not going. Okay. You already have your stuff. You don't need to worry about it.
Sorry, what was that? My internet went.
Vexing must remain in the cargo bag. They do not chain him at this point in time. They're too afraid of him, actually. But he is allowed to roam the cargo bay. But he cannot come down to where the crew is up. The crew is. And by the way, the other person that's on that in the cargo hold is Albert. So. But also off of the cargo hold is the quartermaster's quarters and Fish Guy, the cook. They have their quarters down there on that level. Okay. Anyways. You all...
Hey. I'll just go, hey, Mira, there's another bard on board. Seems rather intrigued by you.
Yeah, I know. I just like teasing him a bit.
Well, maybe you should talk. You know, just strike up a... We could use all the allies that we can get.
Yeah. I'll give it a think.
All right. You guys, and those of you that are going to the quartermasters, get down there to the room. She's sitting there. She looks at all of you.
How's you doing?
I have a question for all of you.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I know better. Captain Tupalsa. He's a wizard. And a pirate. He can blow up ships with his ability. So I'm not a fool. I know that you cannot take him. However, if we capture another ship, and you were put onto that crew, the prize crew, because it's called a prize, and you were put on the prize crew, what would you do?
Leave the bastard.
Captain,
just sail off.
The captain wants to create a fleet. He wants to control the pirates. The pirates are called the Lordship of the Isles. It's a massive number of islands. The captain is working with a group that is to gain control of the Lordship of the Island. Would you be willing to oppose him?
Yeah, he's a bit of a dick.
Or no. Remember, this is the quartermaster telling you. It's all right. You each have a locker. I will give you each a lock for that locker. We currently don't have it. I will, and stuff will back in your locker in the morning. Here's the deal on this. So, when the time comes, when you can, Captain needs to be stopped. The deal. want you to consider this. It would mean that you would be, I don't know how you want to do it. Become your own pirates, become your own admiral, and take him on. It's probably the easiest way that I can see happening with it. But this needs stopped. If him and his allies gain control of those islands, it will be a disaster for the entire continent.
Can I sense motive to see if she's telling the truth?
Yes, you may.
Thank you very much.
It's a stealth 10 roll to visit Vexing. Imidine, yes, it would require a stealth roll. Yeah. He's telling the truth.
Okay. I would like to ask, I'm just going to say it in character. So who are his allies? How many people does he have?
His allies are a group that control countries.
Oh, you know, only the Illuminati. Nobody major.
They are called the Scarlet Brotherhood. And now Ray will go past his paintings.
So he's got some backing then.
Scarlet Brotherhood control four. At the moment, the Scarlet Brotherhood control four countries that I know of.
Can I make a knowledge check on that?
On the Scarlet Brotherhood. Yes, you may. You are a bard. You may make it. Do you have? Does anybody have local knowledge?
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Is that what the role would be? Yeah.
I believe it would be history,
local knowledge
and history would be the two roles, or religion. You could also make a roll of religion.
Should I make a roll for local knowledge then?
Yes, please.
Okay.
And that's 14 because of the bard thingy.
Right.
Oh, we got another 20.
Wow.
Boom. Fucking 20. I know everything.
All right, pot man, calm down.
Okay. All right. So those that rolled... Okay, 14... Okay, the 14, you know of the Scarlet Brotherhood. They are... they have invaded the country... You know they have invaded the country called Onwall. And you know that they have taken over another group of islands that's called the Sea Barons. And I'll bring up a map here shortly so you can put that. But you don't know of anything further than that. You just know that they're a mysterious group. Ray, what you know is that they're a religious order. They're known as a religious order. For the most part, they are very secretive. Their capital, their location of their capital isn't even. However, Elora.
Elora, what does she know?
They are worshippers of the god of destruction. They are
wonderful.
They are lawful evil. They are the ultimate of lawful evil. These guys are the fucking empire. They are in a lot of ways. But they work behind the scenes. They are basically they corrupt the advisors behind countries and then take them over. That's how they.
Like I said, they're the fucking Illuminati.
They are the Illuminati. Yes, they are. You, when you said that, I was smiling because I knew you get it right. They are the Illuminati.
I mean, you know how often I get this right. You know?
But they're awful. They have a number. Now I'm going to switch to the map. They are a number of evil monks involved. As in,
yeah,
monks. You get lashes if Amity gets you. And I know you can't see the mapping game. Hold on. I'm getting there. I'm moving you over. I'm gonna move you over before I can see it.
Now, yeah, not the kind of lash, not the kind of monk that Allure is.
No, not the kind of monk. No, we're talking martial arts evil. We're like the evil martial art part.
So they're like the Shaolin monks, only evil. Okay.
Yeah, they're evil Shaolin monks is what they are. Okay, so I was wrong. It's the Sea Princes. Okay, so what they... Scarlet Brotherhood, you're looking at the map, and you can see the map on D20, or you can look in the thing. Okay, see where the Lordship of the Isles is? Over here? This is where we were talking about... I mean, it doesn't do it justice. There's thousands of islands over here. You, by the way, right now are here. Up in Woolly Bay. That's where you guys are right now, is Woolly Bay. Lordship of the Isles is where the fight's taking place. Onwall, you can see Onwall kind of is right where... kind of in a very strategic position, shall we say. The Palm Arch is, Fluffy knows about that. That's where actually Fluffy is from. That's where the orcs have taken over. So this is the orc horde right here. This is the horde. The best way to describe the Palm Arch, it's the horde from World of Warcraft. So, you're way up here right now. Where the fight is way down here. But if they control that area, they already control the Sea Princes over here. Hold of the Sea Princes is already part of the Scarlet Brotherhood. And then there's the jungle that I was talking about, the Amito jungle. So having the naval power here, having the naval power here, and closing this off here, look how powerful the Scarlet Brotherhood becomes. So that's their plan. Oh, and by the way, there's a dungeon in the middle of this little area right here. Don't go there. Okay.
Is that the Tomb of Horrors?
That is the Tomb of Horrors. Yes, that is the Tomb of Horrors.
I'll pass. Nope.
So.
At least not right now, unless we want to die.
Yeah.
Yeah, fuck it, let's go.
Yeah. So, okay, so that gives you an idea of the overall situation we have here. And so she says, I will get you your items will appear back in your lockers by morning.
Thank you.
So, do you require anything else from me? I cannot openly rebel against my captain. But doesn't mean I can't help you somehow. And I wouldn't openly rebel against Captain Barnabas, because, but chances are, he'll put Plug in charge he'll put Plug in charge of a prized ship, and it'd be a whole lot easier to overthrow him.
One thing you could do with us for us is give us a private room so we can discuss some things on our own.
We can. I will arrange with Fish Gut that you can use one of the storage rooms of the kitchen for such a purpose.
Laura will speak up and say, "You wouldn't happen to have
some holy what?
Holy water."
I have unholy water.
Can't you make that, Tobin?
If you had the time and the ability to make it, the moment.
Exactly, which is why I'm asking if they have any.
No, they do not.
Okay, because
you just ask if they have any.
No, they do. They do. Hold it. They do. I just discovered it. Yes, they do. But I would have to charge. I would have to.
Just needs holy water. Just.
I have to charge for it, though, and do understand. Cannot just take it out of the stores. The captain comes down and audits me quite often. I can give you your stuff back because you're in a separate locker that doesn't count towards the crew stores. But I do have some. I just don't have to sell it.
Well, I don't know how many vials of holy water. It's probably something.
It's 25. It's like 25 gold per. Vial. Pretty expensive stuff.
I'd only need like 3 or 4 vials, wouldn't I?
Something like that.
You know, to effectively just start making my own.
The bigger thing is that you would need to make it. You'd have to have the consecrated font to make it. You don't have a consecrated font to make it. You'd have to be able to make one of those first. You know what I'm talking about, the shallow bowl that would has to be blessed and all that crap. You would need to make that or be able to get one of those to make holy water. All right, guys, we are about to the end, and we're actually to a good stopping spot unless you want. Because
whatever you do.
Because, right? Am I correct? I'm looking at Joe.
What do you mean?
That's 11. It's about 11 o'clock your time, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Because that's where we usually cut off. So I want to. This is a good stopping spot. That now you kind of have a goal, a little bit more of a goal. What the heck is going on outside?
Sounds like a storm.
Yeah, it's like all of a sudden, just... I'm like, yeah. Okay. This place... Storms in Nebraska start here and go east. That's just the way they are. So I'm not surprised it's starting up.
Yeah, that's definitely storming.
Surprised my alarms aren't going off. I have a weather alarm.
Yeah, I see the storm. It's a big one going right through, but dude, it looks horrible.
Oh, yeah.
All right, the next time I go outside, I need...
Yeah. Okay. All right, so let's call it here because, you know, I'm kind of worried about that storm being right on top of me all of a sudden, too, so...
That'd probably be a good idea.
Yeah. So thanks a lot, guys. Hopefully we're back on track. We just need to get Fluffy here. And we'll go from there. And thank you, everybody that's been watching. And we should have some fun. 2 weeks from now will be the next game. And tomorrow will be Star Wars at the same at 6 p.m. my time, 8 p.m. Eastern. And by the way, I'm looking for about two more people on that.
For Blue Moon, for him to go fuck that shit, right?
Yeah.
What? Sorry?
Yeah. Yeah, now Blue Moon could go sleep.
Yeah.
All right, guys. Have a good one. Thank you very much. We appreciate it. And, hey, we're back on track after 3 months and a heart attack. Can't beat that.